MD, CEO of Bombay Stock Exchange, respected Sri Ashish Kumar Chauhan, my colleagues, Honorable Minister for Finance, Yarramala Ramakrishnadu, Honorable Minister for Municipal Administration, P. Narayana Garu, my team members, respected leaders in different departments, members of Bombay Stock Exchange, senior leaders from industry, officials from Government of Andhra Pradesh, members of media, ladies and gentlemen. I am very happy. Just now, MD and CEO has rightly mentioned, today I came here for listing ceremony of Amaravati bonds. He made it very clear. 26th was our Independence Day. 25th, they have done. Under the same time, within 1 hour, we are able to get it nearly 1.5 times to our bond. I am very happy. This is the trust investors are having. This is the trust people are having on Amaravati and Government of Andhra Pradesh. You know very well. Earlier, I developed Hyderabad. Same story at that time. People ask me, where is money? And also, we used to think traditional way. Even Hyderabad, we didn't have flights also. First flight, I want to have international flight to Emirates. At that time, Emirates flights are willing to fly to Hyderabad, but our rules are not permitting. That is the story. I had a very difficult time to convince the then Prime Minister. Then finally I accepted. That is how open sky policy has come. Then we had land. We didn't have water also. At that time, World Bank asked me to charge 20 rupees for later, then only we will finance. Then I decided to go ahead with government expenditure. Within 1 year, I was able to bring water 5 TMs to Hyderabad from Krishna River. That is how we solved the problem of water problem. Then I had a detailed action plan. One is infrastructure. Infrastructure is very crucial for any project. Then I started building infrastructure in Hyderabad. Then I have seen so many airports also. Even Frankfurt, even Dubai, even Singapore, all these airports I have seen. But ultimately, everybody was saying $1 trillion or billion, $1 billion, like that, everybody $3-4 billion. But ultimately, I calculated even less than $1 billion, we can develop a city, cap, this is an airport. That is how first time in India, I request the government of India to finance. They said we don't have money. Then I requested them to accept Greenfield Airport in the first time in India. Then we invited tenders. 5,000 acres of land I have given. That is Hyderabad Airport today. Less than around 2,500 crores or 2,000 crores, we are able to build that airport. Finance is not a problem. Today, if you see, that airport alone is bringing or building 15 to 16% of GSTP in Telangana state itself, one airport. That is the strength of airport. Then naturally we have built one of the best outer ring road you have seen. Hyderabad, nowhere in the country. That is 161 kilometers outer ring road, 8-lane road I conceived at that time. We borrowed money. Because of that road, Hyderabad is rated one of the best city now. Then Cyberabad, we are able to build. All knowledge economy, name any company in the world, they have come. But always one should have vision. And at the same time, to make it a reality, one should market it and execute the project in a big way. That is how, within 9 years' time, we are able to create that city. And ultimately, that city today, with excellent ecosystem, it is moving forward. I am very happy for that. Very rare occasion again. At that time, I built a green brownfield airport city. Now, destiny forced me to develop greenfield city now. This is another capital. Always, to build a capital is very difficult. To get an opportunity, it is a rare opportunity. It is a lifetime, even sometimes so many people may not get lifetime opportunity also to build a capital. When I started this capital, generally after bifurcation, you know very well, we are forced to go to Amaravati. Even there is no Amaravati at that time. I named it as Amaravati capital. We don't have land. Then story began. I can explain to you how we have done systematically within 3-4 years time. First 1 year we were in Hyderabad. Then only we started this building, the city. One example I will give you. Two turning points here. I don't have land. One idea. That is land pooling. I told my farmers, you give me land, I will build a capital with the support of Singapore government. Then ultimately, you will get better valuation compared to now. 5 times, 6 times, even 7 times, you will get better value. Then they accepted without paying money. 35,000 acres of land I was able to mobilize. That is the trust this government is having. Then after this land, how to build up? Then I went to Singapore. I had earlier connections with Singapore government. That government always believes honesty, integrity, and also values. When I went there, I asked them one thing. I want to build a capital. During elections, I announced, I'm going to build another Singapore in India. You help me in building the master plan details. Then I told them I can pay money, but if I call tender, all these procedures will take so much of time. Why can't you do free of cost? They took to the central cabinet within 15 days time. They gave him master plan details, 3 phases. One is Amaravati city and also Amaravati capital, Amaravati region, all these details. Within 9 months, without taking even one pie, they are able to give me. That is how we are able to give this shape. Friends, you are all aware, Amaravati is a beautiful place, historical name. It is a Indra's capital. So for all gods, Indra is the ruler. In this background, Amaravati will be the best capital in the world, not world class. I am very happy MD and CEO has mentioned world class capital. I am not convinced about it. I am talking one among top 5 in the world. That is our concept. 100% I am confident will make it. With this background, I wanted to present to you very Andhra Pradesh, I want to tell you 4% of India's population and also 8th largest state of India with 13% of India's coastline. As on today, $124 billion economy. But my idea is I want to take $1 trillion economy, dollar economy by 2029. If you see here, I number one in IT and also electronics e-governance. We are having 14 ports. Already 6 are in existence. Another 6 ports we are developing. 12 airports, each district 1 airport. Already 8 are in, 6 are in existence. Others we are developing in a big way. Last 3 years, our growth rate is 10.5%. Average double digit growth. This is the first. No other state has grown this type of growth. In spite of new state, so many problems. Even in attracting private investment, we are number one. If you see here, consistently we are growing. First year, 13-14, our growth rate is only 6.96, then 9.20, then 10.60, 11.07, 11.22, in spite of so many hurdles, you are all aware, economy, how it is going in India. Even then, our aim is to grow 15%. I have to grow CAGR 12%, another 15-20 years, to make Andhra Pradesh a developed state. I am confident we will make it. If you see here, All India level 7.18, 7.93, 7.11, 6.60. But our growth rate is consistently, we are moving forward. I am confident this year we'll cross 12 to 13%. We have prepared our vision to be among top 3 developed states in India by 2022, to be the number one state in development and happiness by 2029, and also to become a leading global destination by 2050. For this, if you see, by 2029, $1 trillion economy, per capita income is $16,017, and also accelerating economic growth 12% CAGR, enhancing labor productivity from 4.7 to 16. If you see here, State of the Year Award by CNBC, so many awards. Among the top 3 states in attracting FDI, 2016. First state in e-commerce, e-governance, technology initiatives. Around 500 national, international awards our government got. Ours is one of the best team we are having, just like your Bombay Stock Exchange. Most efficiently we are dealing. Same thing, we are working. We are doing extremely well. Even everywhere, people are recognizing us. Ease of doing business, we are number one. I am not satisfied with this. We wanted to be distant number one, one among top 5 in the world. Always, we want to be top 5 in the world. That is how we are working in that direction. If you see the Amaravati, this is Amaravati is envisaged to be one of the happiest cities, encompassing the highest standards of livability and infrastructure with a thriving economic environment. Always, I am putting emphasis on happiness. Recently, all over the world, United Nations is doing happiness index. As a matter of fact, India has slipped from 122 to 132. same time Andhra Pradesh from 74, we are able to improve 44. Why I am saying here, always I am talking about happiness. It is a wonderful time for all of us. Why I am saying, technology is a big handy for us. India is very strong in technology. In three areas, if you see, one is India is having demographic dividend, better than America. Compared to America also, we are having large number of English speaking people. And also technology, we are very strong. Every four IT professionals, one is an Indian. Among Indians, among four, out of four, one is from Andhra Pradesh. That is our strength, core competency and technology. That is the biggest advantage. Even if you see Google, Microsoft, all CEOs from India, even Nadella Satya is from Andhra Pradesh. This is how things are happening. Nowadays, what I am saying, you are seeing Bombay Stock Exchange. Everything, if you imagine, it can be done. That is the advantage present generation is having with technology. Earlier, I promoted information technology for 15, 20 years. Because of information technology, Hyderabad has become a knowledge economy. After that, our people have migrated all over the world. If you go to now Silicon Valley, highest per capita income are not Americans or Jewish, but they are from Indians. Among Indians, they are from Andhra Pradesh. Every person is doing extremely well. Highest per capita income. Here, today, at that time, I promoted information technology. Now, data is very important. If there is data, and at the same time, if you can use knowledge with innovation, put it at an information technology platform, and you can produce outcomes, scale is the matter now. It may be village, it may be mandal, locally, nationally, internationally. It is possible today. It may be health, it may be agriculture, it may be entertainment, it may be education, anything for that matter. So we are living in that excellent advantage. If you see earlier, India is short of power. We used to have so many problems and also so much of pollution. So much of corruption also. Today, with renewable energy, solar and wind, sun is very kind towards us. India is a hot country. That is the biggest advantage. My state is Sunrise Andhra Pradesh. I named it with some intuition. Now that sun is helping me in producing solar energy in a big way. Now solar energy is coming around less than 3 rupees, 2 rupees 50 paisa or 3 rupees. In future, I am 100% confident solar energy will come at the rate of 1 rupee 50 paisa or 2 rupees. If you can imagine 2 rupees, if you can produce power, India will become manufacturing hub, not only for India, for the global community. That is how things are going to happen. And also pollution we can control. If you can control pollution totally, that energy levels will be different. Green economy, we can go in a big way. If you see here, this is the city, 8,603 square kilometers capital region area, 217 kilometers capital city area, 3.5 million population, 35 billion GDP by 2050. It is only a conservative. 1.5 million employment, 9 cities, 27 townships, 100 parks, 80% public transportation. Hyderabad, 161 square kilometers outer ring road. This is 189 kilometers outer ring road. There is inner ring road, 80 kilometers inland canals, and also 33,000 kilometers cycle path. I want to develop cycle path, walking path, all these things. This is the biggest, I told you, world largest successful voluntary land pooling. 27,577 farmers, 33,740 acres of land. And also 60,115 plots we are able to give back to the farmers. Now it is an excellent case study for London School of Economics and Political Science, and also Harvard Business School, and also World Bank. If you see, without investment, we are able to empower farmers, we are able to get land in a big way. This principle is very clear, 5, 10, 15. 5 minutes, emergency facilities. 10 minutes, open space and recreation. 15 minutes, walk to work. This is the principle we are establishing in this capital. If you see here, 30% blue-green space in city. 80 kilometers inland waterways. That is the beauty of the city. Waterways, 100 parks, 7 islands, one of the best islands. 21 kilometers both sides riverfront. Even it may increase because we are constructing 2 more reservoirs on Krishna. If we see as on today, all government buildings to be rated green rated, I am planning to reduce the temperature 7 to 10 degrees. It is possible. We wanted to prove it because of green cover in a big way, and also water bodies and so many initiatives. We want to reduce the temperature. It will be pollution free, CO2 neutral. That is what I'm thinking. Anybody from Bombay, you wanted to have pleasant life, more lifespan, come and settle in Amaravati and come for business to Mumbai. 100% electrical vehicles, we are going ahead. 35% of overall power usage to be renewable, but ultimately state is going 100% renewable energy now to reduce the cost and also to control pollution levels. If you see here, this is 3,200 kilometers dedicated walking and also cycling tracks, 80% public transportation. I told you 10 minutes principle, that is how we are working. And also, if you see here, 3D city model with BAM integration, first ever city in the world. Now Singapore and other cities are following because that is a brownfield city. They are improving further, but we are going building information modeling. Dassault company, we are discussing with them, simulation model, so that well in advance we will plan it, we will work it out, and then wind blow, everything, temperature, sun, everything, how to module, and also emergency services, everything we are working on this model. We are having 9 cities. One is government city, sports city, finance city, tourism, health, electronics, knowledge city, and also justice city, and also media city. All these cities, again, we are having 27 townships, so that anybody will have 5 to 10, 15 minutes principle also. And also here, in a big way, employment, we are planning to create nearly 1.4 million employment over a period of 25 years, and economy also. We are having plus 9% per annum, but we are planning 12% minimum growth rate. We are going to create 1,20,000 crores economy in 25 years' time. For this project, I am spending so much of time. Every Wednesday, it is Amaravati day for me. I am spending 2 hours. I am guiding my team. They are doing extremely well. And at the same time, if you see here, world best organizations were engaging. McKinsey and consultancy, strategic management, and also financial, how to manage finances, everything. Foster's and Partners, master plan architect to the government complex. Sarbana, master plan consultant, and also RCD's blue consultant, CH2M, program management consultant, GIIC, infrastructure consultant, Singapore development partner, Japan, trade and technical assistance, UK, investment promotion technical assistance, Australia technical assistance, China technical assistance and sister agreement, capacity building and financing, AIB. What I am saying, we are going with everybody, countries. I want to learn what they have done, their experiences. I want to take their assistance also in promoting this city. That is how some consultants, some governments, we are working with them. For the last 44 months, I told you land, planning, Amaravati master plan for government complex, one of the best iconic buildings we are working, design, architectural design, for assembly, High Court and Secretariat completed. Master developer for startup areas, already private institutions like VET, Amrita, and also SRM, multiplier, multiple higher education institutions, social infrastructure. And also if you see here construction, as on today, 28,000 crores worth of works are going on. By February, all these works will be completed. If you see, this is the iconic building. This is the, I can say very proudly, this will be the first of its kind in India itself. That is the building we are conceiving. Excellent water. In water, this assembly building. I made Amaravati as a people's capital. This tower, they can climb the tower. From there, they can view the Amaravati totally. That is how we are making. In what entrance also, in water we are taking up. This is the best iconic building we are creating. This is High Court. This is also iconic. One of the best High Court, best of its kind, we are building High Court. If you see all secretariat buildings, 5 towers we are having, another 2 towers, one of the best towers. Even I can compete with private people also, corporate sector also, in creating wealth. Always we have to compete best in the world, and also best facilities I want to give, then productivity will increase. Earlier we used to think, if you give AC, it is a comfort. It is not a comfort now. It is a essential. Why I am saying, you want to get more productivity, you have to provide good infrastructure, good amenities, then only you can do that. That's why even my secretariat, transit secretariat, is totally air conditioned now. Earlier, you know, all our offices, how it will look. Today, if you see my secretariat, it is better than corporate. Tomorrow, it will be the best at for best corporates. That is what I told my architect. You compare Google, Microsoft like that, so that I can extract that type of productivity from my people. This is one more already Ascendas and Semcor, Singapore companies. We are having a consortium with them. Amaravati Development Company, we are working with them. Around 1600 acres of land, they are going to develop in course of time. Already work has been started. It is going on. The aim is 1,25,000 families, 2,50,000 employment, 1,15,000 crore investment they are going to bring now. So I am earning money by encouraging my Amaravati Development Company also. 42% we are having, 41%, 58% I have given to these two companies, one of the best companies. We are working with them. If you see here, universities, best universities, WIT, AMRUT, SLRI, SRM, these are all the best universities we are able to attract. Schools also best schools in the country. 8 top schools, including top, India's top. Already they are in 7. And also international business schools, ICSC, under CBSC, all curriculum we are attracting there. Hotels, 8 global hotels, that is a 5-star, 6-star, 7-star, all these things we are attracting. Hospitals also, best hospitals in the country, Indo-UK Initiative Health Center, and BR Shetty from Dubai, and also NMC. These are all LV Prasad, so many institutes we are attracting as on today. Our concept is here, I wanted to build best in the world in the initial stage. It may be hotels, it may be college, universities, it may be schools, it may be tourism spots, everything. What I want to request all of you, it is right time for you. You can promote this type of investment. There is an advantage for initial mover. As a matter of fact, I wanted to attract people so that I have to give some incentives. Tomorrow, I may not need to give incentives. People will come on their own, then I can charge them also. That is the attraction we can create tomorrow. It is a very interesting concept we are building on tourism. Sky is the limit for tourism. So either resorts, golf courses, miles, leisure, so many things. It is only according to what are all the imagination. And also sports, one city we are building. Ultimately, India never hosted Olympic Games as on today. It is very bad for us. I am prepared to host Olympic Games in Amaravati. I am offering also. Earlier also I offered. Now I can build one of the best infrastructure. And also if you see Media City, future is for media. If you can see all media for that matter, either integrated business model, broadcasting, even social media, so much of work, even content for broadcasting. Even we are having one biggest advantage I can tell you, we are having real-time governance. There is Aadhaar. Now I am able to synchronize people's hub. Every family members I am able to synchronize. Just like Aadhaar, I am establishing Bhudhaar. Every piece of land will have an identity and also authentication so that nobody can tamper records. Tomorrow, just like our stock exchange, I can sell and I can transactions I can do total land on real time. So that is another thing. And also comprehensive financial management system. All my government is on comprehensive management financial system. Every transaction I can know real time, either receipts and expenditure to the last mile. And also e-office. I am able to establish e-office now. So that last mile onwards, every file will be tracked. So that it will be more efficient and also it is going on very well. Apart from all these things, e-Pragati project is one. We are integrating everything. Content, every home I am correcting 15 Mbps fiber connectivity, bandwidth I am giving. So that 250 channels and also internet, video conference, and also 3 telephones with Wi-Fi. I am charging only 149 rupees. Now I am providing all content through Content Corporation. Anybody can have cooking or agriculture or entertainment or they need some animal husbandry, any content for that matter, outsourcing or networking, or we will create our own content for education also. We are able to provide all these things. And also if you see Justice City, this is where we are making one of the best justice city, not only High Court, even ultimately legal services complex, alternative dispute settlement centers, paralegal services, law school, everything for that matter, and also health city. Ultimately, I want to attract health tourists in a big way, and government city. This is administrative capital we are working. And also, if you see knowledge city, future is in knowledge, best knowledge available in the world, I am bringing to this city. Electronic city, this is one more industrial park, construction city, multimodal logistics park, everything. Financially, finance. I am requesting MD, CEO of Bombay Stock Exchange to have his innovation and incubation center in Amaravati. I can provide you one of the best resources there. And also future is for innovation. I am 100% confident this city will have fintech and also banking and regulatory, everything we are planning. You are all aware, this is the beginning. We have to do so much of transactions here. I am going to work with you. And also if you see our economy, just now I am talking to CEO and MD, 2.5 trillion US dollars economy. Now 30% saving, 750 billion dollars saving every year. That is only 7%. India is having an advantage of growing 10 to 12%. I am planning 15%. India can grow minimum 10%. If India grow 10%, it will grow 15%. 10 years, if you see, $10 trillion saving. Our infrastructure needs, according to him, it is a matter of fact, 2 to 4 trillion. Now, government of India is estimating only 1 trillion. To mobilize 2 to 4 trillion US dollars, there is no problem at all. Only problem trust, and also decision making, and also proper execution. If you can prepare all these things properly, money is not the question of all, constraint at all. In this regard, you have seen now, our Amaravati is a case study. You are going to see in the near future also. I am assuring all of you, with the trust, you invested so much of money with us, first of its kind. And at the same time, not only investing money, be active participants in development. That is my request for all of you. I am building a world best capital, green field city, and also it will be CO2 neutral. Not only talking on slogans, but we are going to implement 100% with true spirit, with technology driven, and also CO2 neutral, and also renewable energy, and also total reusable of all the resources. This is where we are planning. I am very happy to be with you. To create a wealth is not a big problem. And at the same time, if you are having proper policies, proper execution, if you produce outcomes, money is always available. When you do more efficiently, you will get cost-effective finance also. You will get that advantage also. That is where our government is working. I am confident. Earlier we had done, even now we are capable of delivering all these things. With people like you, you had so much of trust on us. I am giving an assurance, we won't betray you. We will prove our truthfulness and also sincerity in delivering our outcomes. I am really thanking you who are all invested. I cannot reveal names, so I don't want to reveal. I will know after some time. So those who are all invested, you visit Amaravati, you had a first-hand information. Seeing is belief, then you will have a first-hand information. On the basis of that, you can talk, you can participate Amaravati growth story. With this, I'm thanking all of you.